Mechanism of walking. First, to start with, by transmission of body weight. The body weight is transmitted from vertebral column to the sacrum. Then each 50% of the body weight is transmitted to each sacroiliac joint. In a standing position, the body weight on each side is transmitted from sacroiliac joint to hip joint, then to the femur. The lateral condyle of the femur receives the most of the weight due to obliquity of the femur. Each tibia receives 50% of the body weight from the femur, and tibia transmit it to the talus. The fibula has no role in transmission of body weight because there is no articulation between fibula and the femur. The talus transmit 25% of body weight backward through the calcaneus to the heel, while other 25% is transmitted from talus forwards. In sitting position, 50% of body weight transmitted from sacroiliac joint to the ischial tuberosity. This is transmission body weight here from vertebral column to the sacrum, then 50% on each side, 50% also to the lower end of the femur, to the tibia, to the talus, then 25 forwards and another 25 backwards. Walking mechanism consists of two phases, its stance phase and the swing phase. The stance phase or first phase starts when the heel reaches the ground. It is supporting phase where one foot rests on the ground, supporting the body and the lower limb acts as a rigid column. The other foot leaves the ground with forward movements to take the step. The following will occur: foot is slightly inverted and the arches accentuated, the knee is extended and locked to carry the body weight. The whole body is carried above one leg, which is fixed to the ground, and the arm of the same side swing forwards with the opposite leg. At the end, the foot raises due to powerful plantar flexion by soleus and gastrocnemius muscles. The second phase, or swing phase, starts by the end of the stance phase. The knee joint is unlocked and then flexed. The foot becomes dorsiflexed until the heel touches the ground to start another cycle. The walking cycle alternates in the legs. In running, the movements are similar to walking, but heels don't touch the ground and depends entirely on the forefoot. In jumping, takes off of the feet occurs in the same time. This is walking, different stages, stance phase and the swing phases. This is during walking. This is the muscles which are involved during walking mechanism. Gluteus minimus and the medius prevent tilting of the pelvis here to the opposite side when the opposite limb is off from the ground. This is running here in 4 feet only. The heels don't touch the ground. Types of gaits. Number one, dipping gait when there is unilateral paralysis of gluteus medius and the minimus. Number two, waddling gait or duck gait walks as duck due to bilateral paralysis of gluteus medius and the minimus, or coxavara when the angle between the neck and shaft of the femur is less than normal, 125. Or in myopathies, Duchenne type, congenital disease affecting the muscles. Circumduction gait when there is paralysis of one side of the body, as in cases of hemiplegia. High stepping gait occurs in case of foot drop due to many causes, as common peroneal nerve injury. Number five, scissors gait due to bilateral spasm of the adductor muscles of the thigh. Number six, propulsive gait. This is seen in Parkinson's disease. Here, an attempt to move the body forwards. Number seven attacks a gate. This is also known as broad-based gate. It occurs in alcoholic intoxication or cerebellar ataxia, injury to the brain, and polyneuropathy seen in diabetes mellitus. The other types of gates are listed. This is types of gates here. This is Parkinson's gate here.